It's Wednesday of Passion Week. Each day after Jesus' triumphal entry, Monday and Tuesday, Wednesday, each day he goes into the temple courtyard and teaches. He has presented himself as king. There is no going back at this point. The crowds have been whipped into a frenzy. They are excited. They think, they know in many instances that the Messiah has come, although he will be unlike any Messiah that they ever dreamed. The scribes, the leaders, the chief priests are indignant. They have a secret meeting, the Gospels tell us, here on Wednesday, where they plot and seek to kill Jesus. They know he must be stopped. They know that there's way too much momentum that's going on with all the crowds. Suddenly, there's a knock at the door. Judas Iscariot, one of his 12 disciples, interrupts their conversation where they are having on how they might put Jesus to death. And Judas offers and says he will betray them. The scripture says that Satan had entered into Judas during that time, that he was so heavily influenced. Certainly, Judas was not acting against his own volition, but rather had never come to faith in Jesus. What we find is that Jesus has intentionally moved into Jerusalem, presented himself as king, and all the while Satan is working out his own plans, his own demise. Satan cannot help but scheme and attack against God. But what we know is that it's all part of God's plan, that from the foundation of the world, God knew this very moment, this very time, even the plans and heart of Satan. It reminds us of Genesis 50, where the brothers where Joseph says to his brothers, "What you meant for evil, God meant it for good." Brothers and sisters, you need to know and understand all around us that Satan continues to wage war because he knows his time is short, that he devises schemes, that he tries to work against the church, work against the gospel. But the truth of the matter is, no matter what he means for evil, God intends it for good. God is always bigger. He's always stronger. He's always working out his plans. And we can see that abundantly clear in this Passion Week. So you take courage. You have strength. I know in your own life that there are trials, that there are situations that are not going the way that you would want them to go. And yet, God is working. God is moving. Whatever your enemy means for evil, God promises, intends it for those who love him, that he works all things out for our good. So will you be in prayer? Will you be intentional about pressing into the Lord? Will you hold on to the hope of our Savior this week, this Passion Week, as we move towards Good Friday and Resurrection Sunday?